So, let's start again with our inventory. I've cleaned up the project a bit. Keep that in mind. I've basically deleted everything that is inside the inventory. And then from on there, it had like 20 errors. I simply just delete the scripts, to be honest. I didn't keep anything. Okay. So yeah, keep that in mind that you're going to have to do some cleanup by yourself. I believe, yeah, you wouldn't really want to see 10 minutes of video just deleting scripts. Okay, so delete what we have in the inventory of if you want to keep it. But just so you know, we're going to create the inventory again from start. Okay, just take care of the errors. Probably you will just have to delete those scripts. Keep in mind or remove a few namespaces. For example, the state manager had some namespaces. Okay, so let's do this again. We're also going to start with an item. That's a fact. Okay, but we don't really want any instance of the item class itself because it doesn't make sense. Okay, we want to know we have an item, but we also want to know that the item is actually something. So we're going to make an abstract class, and this one is going to take from the it's going to be a scriptable object. Okay, so leave it like this. Let's go and create a weapon. Open this up, and we can also open from the Solution Explorer, we can also open scripts like this, which is handy. Okay, and now our weapon is going to take from item. Let's create the asset menu, and I'm going to say items weapon. Okay, we always know that our weapons are going to have a game object as the model prefab. Okay. Then, well, the weapons can have a bit more behavior or a lot more behavior depending on how you use them. So we'll also treat that over here, but on a later basis. So we have our weapon, which is this, and we have model prefab. We're going to be using instances. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a model instance in here. If you want to, so that you don't confuse them, I'm going to create a new class, and we want header script. Let's remove this. Actually, remove all of this. It's not going to be a scriptable object. It's just going to be weapon or runtime weapon. Okay, let's add the namespace. Because I changed the name, I need to go and change the name from over here as well. Runtime weapon, and it's going to have a public game object. Let's remove the Unity editor namespace. We don't really need that. And it's going to have my model instance and everything else that I might add. We're going to add a weapon hook, for example, in here. Okay, back to the weapon then. Instead of using this, we're going to have a public runtime weapon. Runtime. So basically anything that we create at runtime is going to sit in here. We're going to need an init, public void init, for when we are creating those items. And basically in here we're going to handle the instancing of our runtime. New runtime weapon, then our runtime is going to go and instantiate our model prefab. Model prefab as game object, and this needs, of course, to sit on model instance. And till you actually equipped it, you can say model instance set active, set it to false. Okay, because this is going to be a simple init. Awesome. So, other things we know we're going to need inside our item is definitely going to be the human name. So I'm going to write this UI name. We're going to need icons, inventory icon, or just icon, I guess. Okay, and everything else like descriptions, stuff like that, you can use them in here. Awesome, and yeah, okay. This. Let's go back to our weapon. Okay, so all of this will do. So what this gives me, we can go now into our data and let's create a new folder in here. Or you know what, let's go and create a new folder for items. And here, and I'm going to go create weapons. Create items weapon. And let's do the axe I'm currently having. I'm just going to say axe. And so how do we set up weapons? As with all my other series, you probably already seen, to create a weapon, we make sure we use an empty game object as a pivot that always sits at 0000, and we are free to just place this anywhere we want to. So, okay, just place an empty game object in here, 000, and then parent that under the under the empty game object. Do this as a prefab. Obviously I've already done that, but let's do it again. And I'm simply going to drag this onto my model prefab. And that's it. We have our item. Obviously we might want to add the icons. We'll do something for the icons later on. We're going to automate a few things. So yeah, for now, this will work fine. Awesome, we have our axe. Next, we're going to need something that holds a little bit more data upon the weapon. So that will be our weapon hook. Weapon hook. You will notice that up till now, if you're also watching the Heat series, that these are pretty similar. As a matter of fact, I could have just drag and drop this from the Heat series and they will have worked fine as well, because we are using the same basis for the code. So for, let's see, yeah, we already have a definition for weapon hook, so you know what that means. We need to get our trusty delete and go delete that one, which is here. Okay, I'm doing this just so that I can keep the item again. So what do we know this one is going to have? We know it's going to have colliders, which are all going to be damage colliders. However, I don't really want to get just any collider. First of all, we're going to need an init as well in here. So let's add that. Okay, and let's go and create a new script. We can do this from here. We can create a new class. We can just say sysarp mono behavior and it will take care of the rest. We don't want this to be, yeah, it's actually a mono behavior, okay. We want to name this damage collider. Let's rename this one over here as well. Rename damage collider. Damage collider, and over here we're going to have the onTriggerEnder and, well, okay, we only need the onTriggerEnder. Let's also add an init. And let's also add the weapon hook itself. We need the namespace first. Namespace. And weapon hook WH. Weapon hook WH. And let's rename this to weapon hook. And weapon hook is going to be WH. Let's see why this complains. We already have one damage collider, so let's go and remove that too. Well, okay, in reality, I believe we might not. Yeah, we don't actually need to delete that as well. So let's take all of this. I'm going to cut them. And I'm going to go into this damage collider and let's add all of this. On start, we know this sets this game object layer to 10 because it filters out those game objects. Let's go onto our controller and remove this one. We don't really care for that one, and we're going to be using the same script. We did have a delegate, so we were passing the state manager, and if you are hitting something, it passes the delegate for that game manager. We're going to see that all of that later. Okay, back to our Weborn hook, however, we're going to have a list of all our colliders. Damage colliders. Well, this is an array. A damage collider for this one, let's also add a reference to our. Let's not add a reference to our transfer. Let's just get it from here. Get components in children, it's plural. And any damage collider you've found, any game object actually. So let's do it like this. Damage colliders, okay. Then we're going to do a loop for our damage colliders dot length damage colliders I dot let's add one more reference in here on the damage collider and let's say public void collider collider. On start, we're going to do collider equals get component collider. Okay, then for this one, we can say collider dot is trigger equals true, and this will set up all our colliders for all of this. So where do we actually utilize this? Back to our weapon, and inside our init, we're going to have inside our runtime dot, we're going to add a weapon hook, which is over here, public weapon hook, and this is going to be weapon hook runtime model instance dot get component weapon hook, and we're also free now to actually init this. Okay, now let's this is the setup for our weapons. For our weapons in here, for the actual weapon, we will start, we will add stats and stuff like that. Okay, because all of these are going to be also serialized, and we're going to do a few more things. So let's end this part over here, and on the next one we're going to actually utilize them and instance our items. As always, you know what to do, like, subscribe, and if you like to see more videos, then consider supporting me so I can keep making more videos. I'll see you on the next one.